Sometimes in 2019, myself and my wife, we stepped out in faith looking for a home. And all we had in our pocket that time was just 5,000 tax return that we had, and we stepped out in faith. I remember the first meeting we had with our realtor on a coffee table somewhere in Halifax. She asked us a simple question: what do you want in your home? What are you looking for? And my wife has a great taste. I had big dreams then. And the list was so long. We wanted a three-level home. We wanted a fully furnished and finished basement. We wanted space. We wanted bathroom, full baths on every floor. At a point, the realtor asked us if we ever think we will get this in one single home. And we ended the meeting that beautiful morning, and the search began. We saw a lot of houses that we loved, but all the things we were looking for was not there. We saw a couple of houses that we really loved, and everything we were looking for was there. We said, this is it. Some offers we lost, some offers were rejected. But at the end of the day, we found one home, lo and behold. And when we moved in, we found that everything we said, everything we dreamt, everything we were looking for was present in that home. This is the testimony. We never knew that God was marking our mouth when we were discussing with the realtor. We never knew God was marking our hearts. God was watching us when we were dreaming of our new home. Even to the finishing of the kitchen, my wife wanted a particular color of kitchen finishing, and we found that everything we ever asked for was present in that home, because heaven marked our mouth, marked our voice, marked our heart. And tonight, I join my faith with yours. Whatever you are looking for, whatever you are asking for, in this room as we gather to pray today, heaven will mark your voice. Heaven will mark your mouth. And believe God with you for answers, for miracles, for solutions. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, I thank you for the access that I have to the throne of grace through the matchless name of Jesus. The Lord will heal our land. The Lord will heal our nation. The Lord will heal our community. The Lord will heal you. And the Lord will heal me. Tonight, I believe that healing is coming to your room. Oh Lord, I thank you for the finished work of grace on the cross of Calvary. Praise the Lord. I want to welcome you to the prayer room community tonight. And I believe that as we gather to pray, to ask God tonight, heaven is marking your mouth. Heaven is marking your word. And there will be deliveries of answers in the name of Jesus. Let's have a word of prayer. Our Father and our God, we thank you for this hour. We thank you for another moment to be at your feet. We thank you for the access that we have to the throne of grace through the matchless name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you because tonight we will pray in your will. We will pray in faith. We will pray according to your will tonight. And we will pray in line with your word. We believe that answers are coming speedily. We declare that every request, every heart desire, unheard and unsaid prayers, Lord, we believe that you are more than able to do and to answer us tonight. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Prayer room community, God gave me a word for you. And that word is that God is marking your mouth. Everyone is marking your mouth in the name of Jesus. When heaven mark your mouth, when heaven mark your mouth, let's see what the Bible says in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 12. The Bible says, and it came to pass as she continued praying before the Lord that Eli marked her mouth. I love the way the New King James Version put it. The Bible says, and it happened as she continued praying before the Lord that Eli washed her mouth. Hallelujah. Tonight, God's word for you and for me is that anytime we are in the prayer room, anytime we have opportunity to call upon the name of the Lord, heaven is marking your mouth. Heaven is checking your request. Heaven is marking your desire. Sometimes, like Anna, she was a woman with a broken heart. She was a woman in pain. She was a woman in the waiting room, expecting mother. She was a woman that has been abused for so long. But all these things, Anna did not allow it to get at her. The Bible says Anna continued praying. I want you to know tonight that whatever situation you find yourself, if you will not stop praying, if you will not stop asking God, if you will not stop declaring what you want to see. Hannah in this scripture knew what she wanted, even though she was abused, even though she's in pain, she's bleeding in her heart. But the Bible says Hannah knew what she wanted. And every year she will go into the room, into the prayer room, and pray unto God. And the Bible said this particular year, the prophet of God came and declared that your mouth is marked. Your heart desire is being seen by God. Your crying has been heard by God. And go, there is a miracle on your way. And tonight I come to tell you, heaven is marking your mouth tonight. Heaven is marking your crying tonight. Some of us, we have some prayers that they cannot be said out. But don't worry, even your heart, God is marking your heart. Even your heart, heaven is marking your heart. That reminds me, the Bible says concerning the woman with the issue of blood. The Bible says she said in her heart, if I may touch the hem of his garment, I shall be made whole. Heaven marked even the thought in her heart. And we knew the end of the story. There was a testimony. And as we pray tonight, I want us to start by thanking God. Because whatever we say in this room, whatever we ask in this room, whatever we desire in this room, if we do such in the name of Jesus, the Bible says, my Father in heaven would do it. Isn't that something to be glad for? Isn't that something to be grateful for? I want us to pray and just thank God tonight, because through the name of Jesus, everything we ever desire, everything we ever voice out, everything we ever think, God is able to do it. The Bible says, and whatever ye ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. I want you to begin to pray tonight. Lord, I thank you because according to your word, you say whatever I desire or ask in your name, the Father will give it to me because Jesus must be glorified. And today I thank you because it is another day for the Son to be glorified in my marriage. Today it is another day for the God, for Jesus to be glorified in my life. Today is another day for Jesus to be glorified in my business, in my career, in my academics. Thank you, Father, for giving me the priceless name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for giving me the precious name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you because whatever I ask today, my mouth is marked in the name of Jesus. And heaven is creating a checklist for my request tonight. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. When heaven mark your mouth, it means whatever you ask, whatever you think, whatever you decree, whatever you permit, it becomes a command. It is done. It is settled. That is what happens when heavens mark your mouth. Whatever you ask, whatever you think, whatever you decree, it becomes a command. It becomes settled. Why? Because when you said it, heaven marked it. When you said it, heaven noted it. When you said it, God marked it. And if God marked it, God will do it. Let's see what the Bible says in one of my favorite scriptures. In Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20, the Bible says, now to him that is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we ask or think, according to his power that worketh within us. Hallelujah. What is the Bible saying there? The Bible says, whatever you ask, whatever you think, God is big enough. God is more than enough to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that you ask. So that I know tonight that when you come into the prayer room, when you come to your place of prayer, even when you come to the place of meditation, because there are sometimes in the prayer room, you cannot voice every prayer. You cannot voice the way your heart is bleeding. But God says, whatever you ask or whatever you think, he says he's more than able to do it. And tonight, I want us to begin to declare your thoughts. Begin to declare that my thoughts are possible. Begin to declare that my dreams are possible. Begin to declare that, Lord, I thank you. Because heaven is marking my thought tonight. My thoughts towards my scores. My thoughts towards my academics. My dreams towards my future. Lord, I thank you because you mark it. Lord, I thank you because it is possible with you. Lord, I thank you because you are able to do much more than I think. Lord, I thank you because you are able to do much more than I ask. In the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you because my thoughts are marked. Lord, I thank you because my words are marked. Lord, I thank you because everything I ask for in this room today, it is done. Ekolobo shandra hagalabo sotolobra hagaligeruya. Thank you, Jesus, because you are able to do beyond all that I ask. Thank you, Jesus, because you are able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that I think. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you because my dream is possible. Lord, I thank you because my dream home, my dream job, my dream marriage, my dream cars, my dream sources, it is possible. It is possible. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. When heaven mark your word, when heaven mark your mouth, it means that no word, no promise, no expectation will fail. That is what happens when heaven mark your word, when heaven mark your mouth, when heaven watch you in the prayer room tonight. I come to tell you tonight, as you pray today, as you ask today, no dream, no word, no expectation, no word from God, no promise will fail. How did I know? The Bible says in his word that with God, nothing shall be impossible. The Bible went further to tell us in the word of God in Isaiah chapter 55 verse 11. The Bible says, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. Did you see that? The Bible says every word that is released out of the mouth of God, every promise that is released out of his promise into you, the Bible says, it shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish, it shall fulfill that which I please, and it shall prosper in the things wherein it is sent. That means when God's word is sent to you, when you read the word of God and you receive his promise, and you keep saying it, and you keep saying it, it becomes the word of God in your mouth. And the Bible says that time heaven is marking your mouth. Heaven is marking your word. Heaven is marking your mouth. And the Bible says that word will not return empty. And that is what I come to tell somebody in this room. Your waiting, your expectation will not fail in the name of Jesus. Your promise will not fail. Your word will not fail. Your word will not fall to the ground. I know you've given promise to your landlord that you will pay that bill, to your debt, or to the one you are owing, that you will soon pay. You will pay off your credit card. You will pay off your line of credit. And you are wondering, how am I going to do it with no income, with no expectation. But I come to tell you by the word of the Lord tonight, your word will not fail. Your promise will not fail, because heaven has marked it. If you can tell God tonight, heaven is marking your word. Heaven is marking your voice. I know you promised your children, I will buy you these. I will send you to the best school. I will give you a college degree, a university degree. And you're wondering, how will I be able to achieve these, knowing that I'm a single mother? I declare tonight that heaven is marking your word. Every promise, every expectation over my life, over my family, over my career, over my finances will not fail in the name of Jesus. The Bible says the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. Some of us, we have dreams that are 60, at 40, at 50, we will retire from active service and we will sit back and watch our investment grow and watch our businesses grow. But the things that we are seeing today does not show a green light that will happen. But I come by the word of the Lord for you today. Your word will not fail. Your dream will not fail. Your promise will not fail. God will activate all those promises tonight, because heaven is marking my word. And therefore, I begin to dream a new dream. I declare that I shall retire young. I declare by the word of the Lord, I shall live longer. I declare by the word of the Lord, I have all that I need. I have all that I need, all that I require to give my children the best education. I decree by the word of the Lord, no failed word, no failed promises, no failed expectation, because your word says the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. And therefore, I declare that I'm coming out of debt. I declare that I'm coming out of darkness. I declare that I'm coming out of failure. I declare that I'm coming out of my shame. I'm coming out. I'm coming out. I'm coming out. Idabo sotolobra gadabo shindra haga ligeduya. All my expectation for a glorious marriage, for a beautiful marriage, I declare that I shall not fail. All my expectation to be satisfied with goodies of life, for a fulfilled career, a fulfilling and rewarding career, I declare by the word of the Lord, it will not fail. It will not fail. That dream for my own business, that dream to create job, to create wealth, to be the leader in my country, in my area, to be the head and not the tail, I declare by the word of the Lord, it will not fail. It will not fail. It will not fail. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. What does it mean when heaven mark your word? One thing that the Holy Spirit told me last night while I was preparing for this meeting is that when heaven mark your word, it means never say never. Never say never. It means don't give up on your dreams. It means don't give up on God's word for you, because God will not give up on his word. So when God marks your word, never say never. Let me show you the scripture that the Holy Spirit showed me when I was praying. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 11 from verse 11, John 11, 20 to 21. The Bible says, so when Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went out to meet him, but Mary stayed in the home. And listen to the scenario that played out here. The Bible says, Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother wouldn't have died. If you had been here, my brother would not have died. Hallelujah. But Martha knew that when heaven marks your word, never say never. And she quickly changed that word. He said, but even now, I know God will give you whatever you ask of. And the Bible says, continually in verse 23, your brother will rise again. And Jesus told her, Martha replied, no, that I will rise again in the resurrection. In the resurrection at the last day. But Jesus told her, I am the resurrection and the life. Whosoever believes in me will live. And though he dies, he will live again. So did you see the scenario that played out here? Martha said, I know that if he had been here, my brother wouldn't have died. But immediately she realized that when heaven marks your word, you never say never. And she said, but I know that the fact you are here, the Father will give you whatever you ask for. My brother will live again. And I come to tell you tonight, heaven is marking your word. Never say never. Watch what you say. Watch what you think in crisis, in situations, in pandemic. Never say never. Don't give up when you are in the waiting room. The pain may be high. The loss may be too much. The body may be too much. But I come to tell you that heaven is marking every word you say in this room. In that pain, in that crisis, heaven is marking your word. Never say never. Never give up. Because anything can happen if you believe. All you need is just believe. All you need is just believe. And I want you to begin to thank the Lord tonight. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Jesus, I believe that I will live again. My dream will live again. I believe that this wait will be over. I believe that this storm will be over. I believe that I will not be single forever. I believe that I shall be fruitful. I believe that this storm will be over. I believe that I will be free again. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. In this room today, I join my faith with you. I declare that everything that is dead in your business is coming back to life. Every dead idea, every lost opportunities, they are coming back. In the name of Jesus, if you can say it, if you can declare it, God can do it. I declare in the name of Jesus, I will rise again. I declare in the name of Jesus, I will live. I shall not die. I declare in the name of Jesus, I will overcome this storm. We pray for the nations of the earth, for the countries of the earth. We declare that in the name of Jesus, Africa is healed again. Africa is healed again. Africa is healed again. Africa will see the light again. We declare concerning our continent, North America is made whole again. It's made whole again. God is coming back to the center of our continent. In the name of Jesus, in every heart, in every home, Jesus rule, Jesus reign. I will not say never. I am not giving up on my dreams. I am not giving up on my search for greatness. Because the word of God says, I will live again. I will rise again. I will walk again. I will never say never concerning my visa application. I may have been rejected. I may have been denied. But I know that with God, nothing shall be impossible. I declare tonight
that my application is possible. My visa is possible. My admission is possible. My sponsorship is possible. Kelobo Chandra Hagaligeduya, my scholarship is possible. In the name of Jesus, my bills are paid. Idarabo Chandra Hagaligeduya, Ekolobo Rogodo Bagadegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedegedeged praying will pray.
Another thing that it means, when heaven mark your voice, it means that God has heard your crying. It means that heaven has heard your crying. It means that heaven have felt your pains. It means that God has seen your oppression. He has seen that you have been oppressed, and God is coming for you, and heaven is coming for you. Let's see what the Bible says about that in the book of Genesis, chapter 21, verse 16 to 19. The Bible says in verse 17 in particular, the Bible said, "Then God heard the voice of the boy, and the angel of God called unto Hagar from heaven, 'What is wrong, Hagar? Do not be afraid, for God has heard the crying of the boy where he lies. Get up, lift up the boy, and take him by the hand, for I will make him a great nation.'" And the Bible says in verse 19, the Bible says, "Then God opened her eyes, and she saw a well of water. So she went and filled the skin with water and gave it to the boy to drink." Tonight, I come with the word of the Lord for you. Heaven is marking your mouth. Heaven has seen your crying. Heaven has seen your tears. Heaven has felt your pain. Heaven, God, whenever you come into the prayer room, God sees your pains. Even your own hard crying, God sees it. God has heard it. Even your unseen tears, God has seen it. And God told me to tell you tonight, you are a bleeding woman in the house tonight. God said he has seen that bleeding and will speak an end to that bleeding. Everyone that is bleeding in heart, everyone that is bleeding in your heart, everyone that is hurting, I bring you the word of the Lord. God has seen your pains. God has heard your crying. God says heaven is wiping away your tears tonight. I speak to everyone in the house this night. You have been abused for so long. You have been trampled upon for so long. You have been delayed for so long. But God told me to tell you that heaven has marked your pains. Heaven has marked your struggle. As you pray and cry to the Lord today, the Bible says heaven has heard the crying of the lad. Heaven has heard the crying of the boy. And God opened the eyes of his mother. Tonight, God told me to tell you, your eyes is open. There are opportunities around you. There are new dreams that God is putting in your heart tonight. In the name of Jesus, I want you to begin to thank the King of Kings tonight. Say, "Lord, I thank you for hearing my cries tonight. Lord, I thank you because you have seen my pain tonight. Lord, I thank you tonight because you have heard me. Lord, I thank you tonight because you have seen my pain. Lord, I thank you tonight because your healing balm is touching every hurting heart tonight, every hurting soul. Every bleeding vessel, every bleeding woman, every bleeding heart. We command the balm of Gilead. We command healing tonight because heaven has heard you. And the Bible says, and God opened the eyes of the mother to see solution. Tonight, God is putting solutions in your heart. God is putting new dreams in your heart. God is putting new ideas in your heart. In the name of Jesus, God is showing you a new way out of the crisis, out of the troubles. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you because you are putting solutions in our heart, because you are putting new dreams, new ideas, new business ideas, because you are opening us up to opportunities. We pray for our city. We pray for our city. We pray for our state. We speak to the city of Nova Scotia. Speak about any city that you are living right now. Declare that my city, your crying has been heard. Heaven is putting new ideas, new business opportunities. They are springing up in Nova Scotia. Nova Scotia will become a great nation. Nova Scotia will become a great state, a great city. Nova Scotia will become a great province. Nova Scotia will become great. In industrialization, Nova Scotia is rising. In the name of Jesus, in education, Nova Scotia is rising. In infrastructure, in housing, in economy, we are great. We are great. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Lastly tonight, I want you to know that when heaven puts a mark on your mouth, when heaven puts a mark on your word, it means that there is an atmosphere of miracle over you. It means there is an atmosphere of angelic visitation over you. And guess what? The Lord told me as I was coming here today, he said, in this room that this prayer is going to be prayed, everyone that is praying with me today, whatever time that you are, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the night, God told me to tell you, and I decree over your room, I decree over your device, I decree over your space, there is an atmosphere of miracle. There is an atmosphere of divine visitation. You know what? You are not alone in that room. You are not alone in that marriage. You are not alone in that business. You are not alone in the middle of nowhere in your business, in your finances. God is with you. And I activate atmosphere of miracle in that house, in that room, in that business, in the name of Jesus. When heaven mark your word, heaven create an atmosphere of miracles and divine visitation. And guess what? Anything can happen. Anything can happen. Anything can happen. The last few minutes of this prayer experience, I want you to begin to speak to your atmosphere. Begin to speak to your room. Begin to speak to your word. Because anything can happen. You see, when God wants to do something great, he doesn't just come down and just do it. What he does in the scriptures, he will say, ask whatever you want. Let's see what the Bible says in the book, in the New Testament, how Jesus said it. The Bible says in Luke chapter 18, verse 41 to 43, the Bible says, what do you want me to do for you? Lord, he said, let me see again. And Jesus said, receive your sight. Jesus replied, your faith has healed you. And the Bible says, immediately he received his sight and he followed Jesus, glorifying God. Tonight, God told me to tell you, what do you want me to do for you? Because in this room, there is an atmosphere of miracle. All you need is to just declare. All you need is to cry out to God. Whether your lips is moving or your mouth is not moving, whether your heart is pounding, I want you to pour your heart to the heavens tonight. I want you to declare tonight, whatever you want God to do, there is an atmosphere of miracle in your room tonight. You can carry your phone and carry your device and speak to your account. I speak to my account. I declare by the word of the Lord, this account is coming out of debt. This account is coming out of debt. In the name of Jesus, I speak to every bill in this room. I speak to every bill in this house. It is paid. It is settled. It is fully paid. It is fully settled. Every business that is at the verge of closing down, that is at the verge of being declared bankrupt. As we speak tonight, we pull you out. We pull you out. We pull you out. Every destiny that is sinking tonight, Igalabo godo bagaregedebo sotolo bragadabo shendra hagaligeruya. We pull you out. We pull you out and establish you on the solid rock. Every business, every life, every career that is sinking tonight, we pull you out. Idarabo shendra hagalego rogodo bagadabo godo begedigeruya. There is an atmosphere of miracle in your room. The Holy Ghost is in your room. The angels are in your room. They are waiting for your word. They are waiting for your word. They are waiting for your command. Command your morning. Command your day. Command your morning. Command your day. Speak the word of the Lord over your passport. Speak the word of the Lord over your atmosphere. Speak the word of the Lord over that application. Speak the word of the Lord over that scorecard. Speak the word of the Lord over that promotion exercise. Speak the word of the Lord over that dream in your heart. Begin to call it forth, because there is a miracle happening right now. Touch your wife. Touch your husband. Can speak healing into that body. Touch your wife. If you are trusting God for the fruit of the womb, touch your womb and begin to call forth babies. Idarabo shendra hagalabo sotolo bragadegedegedea. Idaragadabo godo bagadegedegedegedegedegedea. Lekoto koto paragadegedegedea. Because if you can say it, heaven is marking it and God is doing it. Idarabo shendra hagalabo ya. Lord, I declare that every prayer said in this room tonight, it is done. I declare that in the name of Jesus, every prayer that is said in this room tonight, it is done. It is settled. Every heart that is troubled, we declare that peace is coming to your heart. Peace is coming to your room. Peace is coming to your home. Peace is coming to your marriage. Every joy that has been stolen in your life, we declare that joy is restored. Joy is here. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name. Thank you, Jesus. Because every request, every cry tonight, every pain tonight, every struggle tonight, every battle in this room tonight, they are settled in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord, prayer room community. I am super happy to share this room with you today, to share this atmosphere with you today. And I believe God with you that there is an atmosphere of miracle over your room, over your business, over your life. Just keep speaking God's word. Just keep speaking it. Heaven is marking your word. Heaven is marking your mouth. Your thoughts are being marked by heaven. And guess what? Answers are coming in the name of Jesus. I believe that you will share your testimony soon. I want you to share this prayer with your friends, with your neighbor, with everyone on your timeline. And subscribe today if you have not done so. Click the notification button so that you can receive reminders and notification next time we start to pray in this room. God bless you. Heaven has marked your mouth today. An answer is coming to you. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. See you same time next week. God bless you.